Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us talk about the cross-domain and cross-window communication in JavaScript through document.domain and Window.postMessage. The same origin policy is a critical security mechanism that restricts how a document or script loaded from one origin can interact with a resource from another origin. It helps to isolate potentially malicious documents and reducing possible attack vectors. There is no restriction on interacting with the script and resources loaded from same origin. The origin is defined based on the protocol, hostname and port number of a URL. Two URLs have the same origin if the protocol, port and host are same for both. Let us now see the default behavior of interacting the resources between two different origins. So you can see here there is a mydomain.com and sub.mydomain.com. In mydomain.com, there is a index.html. And if you see here, sub.mydomain.com has test.html. So test.html has some simple HTML with some div, inner div with ID. So now index.html, iframing that specific test.html file, sub.mydomain.com, test.html. Now, there is a script in the mydomain index.html file to hide this specific inner div. So inner div and from iframe.contents, we are hiding it. So if you see the behavior, so the script will not able to hide this specific element because the same origin policy block it. The security will block it because this both are considered as a different origin. We have seen the definition of the same origin. So here if you see the host name is different, but the protocol and the port names are same, but still the domain name is different. Even though it's a subdomain, it is considered as a different origin. So the iframe access, the script access to this iframe content is restricted. So let me show that samples maybe. If I go here, if I see here, this is index.html. So I am just doing a kind of, I am keeping a timeout and trying to hide that, that iframe. So then if I go to the frame test.html, this is the symbol inner div, hello. Now, if I go and test the behavior, so let me go and find it. Yeah, if I go to this, I'm accessing that through mydomain.com, but I'm iframing from the subdomain. So if I access this, maybe the timeout we need to wait. If you see here, blocked a frame with origin mydomain.com from accessing cross origin frame. So here it becoming a cross origin frame. So the access is by default, the access is restricted by the browser's security policy. If you see here, the element is not hided also. So while trying to hide this element, getting this cross origin error. Here the document.domain from same origin policy helps to enable the resource access between subdomains and the parent domain. The document.domain mechanism is intended for allowing client-side communication between frames. The page can change its own origin with some limitations. A script can set the value of document.domain to its current domain or a superdomain of its current domain. If set to the superdomain of the current domain, the superdomain is used for same origin checks. Let me show that. Here again, same setup. If you see here, mydomain.com, index.html, then sub.mydomain.com, test.html. Then we are trying to iframe it, sub.mydomain.com, test.html, and trying to access the element within that iframe, the inner div. So, but if you see here, there is a different. So index.html has the document.domain specified as mydomain.com. So the same domain, this is the parent domain. So also if you go to this test.html, again same document.domain specified as mydomain.com. This is the parent domain of this subdomain, sub.mydomain.com. Now the behavior is different. We'll be able to perform this action. So we can access the element within this iframe. And we will be able to hide this. The page will now pass the same origin check. So let me show that. I will go to this. If you see here, there is a index.html. on the same HTML. The only difference is we are trying to specify the document.domain equal to mydomain.com. That is the parent domain, the same domain. We are through this domain, we are going to access this index1.html. Now, if I go to frame test1.html, again, here we are specifying document.domain, the mydomain.com, the parent domain of the subdomain. If you see here in the index1.html, I'm iframing through the subdomain, sub.mydomain.com. So we are saying like use this mydomain.com for the cross origin domain check. So let me access the page now. Yeah, this is the page index.index1.html. Maybe I will open in an incognito window. So go there, inspect. Console, yeah, do this. Hello is displayed now. Let's wait for the timeout. Yeah, now if you see, there is no exception. Also, like the element is hidden. It means it passed the cross-origin check, and also it was able to access the iframe element. But still, this won't allow the client-side resource communication between two completely different domains. Example, mydomain.com and mydomain2.com. So you will still receive the cross-origin error. Here the window.postMessage helps us to communicate between the windows of two different origins. So let us see that. The window.postMessage method safely enables the cross-origin communication between window objects. Example, between a page and a pop-up opened, or between a page and an iframe embedded within it. One window may obtain the reference to another and dispatch a message event on it with target window.postMessage. So the receiving window is then free to handle this event as needed. If you see here, two completely different domains. The first one is mydomain.com and mydomain2.com. The index.html from mydomain.com iframing the test.html from the mydomain2.com. Our expectation here is to hide the inner div element from the iframe based on some criteria. But this won't be supported directly by the browser security policy. Even document.domain won't help here, as this is a two completely different cross domains. The window.postMessage can be used to implement this scenario. If you see here, index.html sending a event message to iframe window. So this is the iframe ID, test frame. We are getting that element. Then element.contentWindow.postMessage. So this is the message, hide. Then this is the origin, like HTTP, then mydomain2.com. Even you can say a star. So it means the event will be sent to like all the windows. So whoever receiving that or whoever registered for that event, they can receive it. But here we are saying only send it to mydomain2.com. So if you go to the test.html here, so there is a event listener. So window.add event listener. So type message. Then this is the event handler, receive message. If you see here receive message, we are checking whether the data is equal to hide. So if it is hide, then we are hiding the inner div. So same thing like whatever we earlier did through that document.domain. So here we are doing through post message. So the hiding, this logic is in the test.html. But earlier it was in the parent window, the index.html. Let us now see the demo. If I go here, like if you see here, there's a index2.html. So it's iframing the mydomain2.com frame test2.html. So also there is a post message. So the ID of this frame is test frame. We are getting that element, the element.contentWindow.postMessage. Then this is the type of the message, hide we are saying. So you can specify any string you want. Then this is the domain, like where this event should be sent. So mydomain2.com, the origin of the target. So here you can even specify star. It means the event will be sent to like all the windows. So who are registered for that can like receive it. Now if I go to the frame test2.html, so adding a event listener of type message, then the handler. So within the handler, like we are checking whether the event is event data is equal to hide. If so, then we are hiding the inner div. Here even you can enable a origin check whether the message is coming from the right origin, our case mydomain.com, so that you can then take the necessary action. Let me now go and access the page. Go here, like, yeah, this is the page. Maybe I will open it in incognito window. So open the console. Okay, just access this. I'm accessing through mydomain.com. So if you see here, listener added. So it's coming from the iframe. So let's wait for the timeout. Yeah, see here, message posted, then hide. So the element is hided. So the through the post message, the image was posted from the parent window to the iframe. Then iframe received the message and taken the appropriate action. So our case, the hiding the element. The document.domain and the window.postMessage functions are very useful to handle the client-side communications between cross-origin windows. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.